Father Harris and I are excited that you join us for Mass during the weekends, and also now available every Tuesday and every Friday, live from St. Thomas More in Boynton Beach. May God bless you. And now, the Holy Mass.
The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Well, Mass is all for today by me, for the living, Dr. Joan and Gerald Pileski, and they are here. Are you here? There you are. God bless you. And it's offered by Jerry. And it's good. They're newlyweds. They're still in the afterglow of marriage. You remember them, right? It started out with something little. They sat beside each other. Jerry moved from this side, and from the back to the front. The next thing you know, he's sitting by her. And then the next thing you know, they're standing together here at the altar. And I'm in receiving their vows of marriage. So great things begin with small steps.
3 years, Father.
Amen. How many?
Three.
Three big ones. Amen. Three of 30 more to go. As we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries of our faith, thanksgiving to God for them, we ask the Lord for mercy and pardon for our sins. I confess, my God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever virgin, all the angels and the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation is made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains, even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that sees for itself is not hope. For who hopes for what one sees? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait with endurance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm, the Lord has done marvels for us.
The Lord has done marvels for us.
When the Lord brought back the captives of Zion, as warlike men dreaming, then our mouth was filled with laughter and our tongue with rejoicing.
The Lord has done marvels for us.
Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad indeed.
The Lord has done marvels for us.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the torrents in the southern desert. Those that sow in tears shall reap rejoicing.
The Lord has done marvels for us.
Although they go forth weeping, carrying the seed to be sown, they shall come back rejoicing, carrying their sheaves.
The Lord has done marvels for us.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, "What is the kingdom of God like? To what can I compare?" seed that a man took and planted in the garden. When it was fully grown, it became a large bush. The birds of the sky dwelt in its branches. Again, Jesus said, "To what shall I compare the kingdom of God? It is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch of dough was leavened." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good things come in small packages. Great things have small beginnings. This is an adage that has tested time and is accurate. I must remind you, too, that very evil things begin with very small acts. You can't help but think about the planting of the Garden of Eden and the Lord placing us in it. It says, if it's man there, and he grows so vast, billions upon the face of the earth now, and we've made a home for so many, it's a great beginning. It came from one small little fellow. But also, there was a lie there. There was a deception. And that grew to encompass all things as well. I can never get over the statement that St. Paul makes here in the Roman letter about how all of creation has been subjected to futility by the one who subjected it. What the world does that mean? Adam's deception, my friends, has affected the world. It has altered it. It is not the garden the Lord planted. It's the one we have planted. That's why it resists us. You have to sweat in order to push the plow, to plant the seed, to get the harvest. And the weather's not on your side. I can assure you that he who plants the seed beneath the sod and waits to see believes in God greatly. For the weather is so unpredictable. Have we not just gone through the unpredictability of weather? With one storm named Dorian heading straight for us at 185 miles an hour winds, and it didn't come. We cleaned out Home Depot. We cleaned out Publix. They were wrong. You can't know. We live our life with so much unknowing. That is why the Lord says you must hope in that which you do not see. Have faith in God. Have faith in me. Our church began from very small beginnings, 11 men in a boat with the Lord. Not very many. But today is vast. She makes a home for so many to find their place in her. Our great church, like our homes, they begin so humbly. And over time, we have the blessing of children, and then we live to see our children's children, if we're blessed by God. And you get like Harry Isabel, the most amazing man who sends a Christmas card every year. And the picture's not wide enough to get all of the children's children's children inside of the darn thing. And I said, you're going to have to get a panoramic view so that you can get a 360 to get them all around you. The man's blessed indeed. I'm always amazed by how one man and one lady can have all of them. And what I love about it is that all of them take care of those two, which is the meaning of all of this, that God made us for each other. Yes, to love him, of course. We're an expression of his love and creativity. But he gave us each other. So we should love one another, my friends. Even the difficult ones. Start with loving a leaf and work your way up to a branch. Before you know it, you might get to your neighbor. And if you're very lucky, to your enemy. And then one day you wake up and realize you don't even have a list of enemies or friends. Then you have reached great maturity. And many can find a home in you. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we begin this day with prayer. May it bear great fruit in our lives and the lives of all whom we meet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We
pray for the farmers and all of those who will go out today to harvest and to plant, to pick and to prune. We will bear the heat of the day and suffer through the drought and the fire. Sustain them as they bring bounty to our lives and our tables. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Through the intercession of St. Isidore the farmer, bless all farmers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for ourselves that what we do here may bear fruit in the years ahead in our families. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine that we offer you, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look, we pray, Lord, on the offerings that we make to you, that whatever is done by us in your service here may be directed above all to your glory there, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, Christ our Lord. For all times and seasons obey your laws, yet you created us in your own image, setting us over this world in all of its wonder. You made us the stewards of your creation to praise you day by day for the marvels of your wisdom and power through Jesus Christ our Lord. With him we join the angels in thanking God every day of our lives. Holy, holy, holy,
holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Proclaim the mystery of faith. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. With Francis, our Pope, and Gerald, our Bishop, and all of the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died
Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence for the coming of the kingdom in the words the Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant us peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Offer one another a sign of peace. that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, Mass is ended.
Amen.